today on Another World.
I'm here to see Dr. Delaney?
No, just to make an appointment.
Problems?
No. On the contrary, I've been remembering some things, and I found that I'm putting some of the pieces back together.
What brought you to Bay City, anyway?
I don't know.
Well, it must have been some kind of connection, friends or family tie of some kind.
Well, I guess you could say a family tie from way back.
An overdose of heroin?
That's the confirmed cause of death.
My mother never used drugs. This is Jordan Scott's handiwork.
Now, Jerry, don't...
Don't what? This is his calling card. That's Jordan Scott's way of getting rid of whatever problems he doesn't want around.
And now, the continuing story of Another World.
Here you are, Mac. One more to sign. The ledger's all yours.
I've been looking forward to this moment since the moment that I heard it was for sale.
Well, you're building quite a publishing empire here in Bay City. I mean, first a book publishing business, then a nationally famous magazine, and now a newspaper.
Well, it was really too good an opportunity to pass up. Besides, I'd really hate to see the ledger go under.
So would I. You know, Bay City can use another newspaper with a strong second opinion.
We hope to give it just that.
I'm sure you will, given some time. Any thoughts about who's going to run the paper?
Yes, as a matter of fact, I've already offered the job of editor to Philip Lyons.
Good. That's a good choice. Has he accepted the job?
No, but he's going to give me his answer when we meet later today.
Well, I hope he takes it.
I do, too.
He's the perfect man for the job. Philip has vitality and imagination.
Yes, and he's also totally committed to whatever he gets involved in. You know, ever since he left us, I've been trying to find some way to entice him back. I'm hoping this newspaper job is just the temptation that he can't resist.
Well, frankly, I don't see how he can resist it. I mean, it's going to offer a lot of challenges to whomever takes it over, and I get the feeling that Philip is a man who likes challenges.
I'm certainly counting on that.
Now, are you going to publish the paper yourself?
No. I've decided to delegate that to someone else.
Any thoughts about who?
Yes. Jamie.
Jamie?
Yes.
Another good idea.
I think so. He's certainly proved himself with Corey Publishing. You give him a job to do, that job gets done, and it gets done well.
Well, he should do you proud, Mac.
I don't have any doubts about that. Besides which, you know, I want to put him in charge of something that's all his own. Something where he doesn't feel that somebody's constantly looking over his shoulder.
Have you heard from him since he left?
No, I haven't, and frankly, I'm a little worried.
Oh, why?
Well, I gave him some things to do for me, you know. I'm just surprised he hasn't checked in, told me how things are going. I certainly hope nothing's happened to him.
Excuse me.
Yes, can I help you?
Yeah, I'm looking for Ada Hobson.
Oh, she's not here right now. She'll be in a little later.
All right, I'll come back later this afternoon.
Well, hey, you want me to tell you we're looking for?
Yeah. You don't know who I am, do you?
Should I?
Guess not.
But maybe you'll tell me, right? So that I can pass your message on to Ada?
Yeah, Mitch Blake.
Lee Hobson.
Hobson? Related to Ada?
Yeah. Yeah, I guess in a way I am.
Yeah, well, I'm glad everything's going so well, honey. Well, Jamie. Honey. Jamie, just don't overdo it, okay? No, I'm not. I just want to make sure you take care of yourself. Mac wants you to have some fun on this trip, too, you know. Okay. No, all right. Yeah, okay, I will. No, I won't forget. Just take care of yourself, okay? All right. Talk to you soon. Yeah, I love you too. Bye-bye. Oh.
Hi, was that Jamie?
Yeah, it was.
What's the matter?
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know? You act as if something's the matter.
Well, I think it is.
Well, what do I have to do, drag it out of you?
I don't know what it is. I just am worried about Jamie.
So how's that again?
Well, just how well do you know Ada?
What's this, answering a question with a question?
Well, I'm not about to go spreading information about Ada to just anyone, you know. And there's a lot of weirdos in the world out there. You gotta watch what you tell people. Oh, I didn't mean to say that you were a weirdo. But you really do have to watch out what you tell people.
That's all right. I know what you mean. But I get the feeling that Ada's the kind of person that can take care of herself.
Well, then you do know Ada.
So I'm told.
Oh, you're that Mitch Blake. Yeah, I've heard about you. For a while there, you were the talk of the town. Coming back from the dead and all.
Right, right. So, who are you?
I'm Lee Hobson.
I think you told me that.
Yeah, I guess I did.
What is it, you're related to Ada?
I'm sort of her stepson.
How sort of?
Well, Charlie Hobson was my father. But I never met Ada until after he died when I came out here for the memorial service. But you know something? It's like I've known her all my life.
Yeah, I think I know what you mean. Since I returned to Bay City, met a lot of people that I feel that I know. Except in my case, I guess maybe it's possible that I have known him.
What's it like, amnesia? I mean, do you remember anything? Your birthday? Whether or not you have any brothers and sisters?
Coming out with a few pieces here and there, mostly by talking to people.
It must be weird.
Can be.
You gonna get better?
Say I will.
Well, at least you're putting the pieces back together. That's a start, isn't it?
Start? Sometimes come up with more questions than answers. That's one reason why I wanted to talk to Ada.
Well, I hope she can help you answer some of those questions.
I hope so, too. Tell her I will come back this afternoon.
All right. Nice meeting you, Mitch.
Good meeting you.
Bye-bye.
Mac, are you going to tell me, is there something wrong with Jamie?
Well, Brian, I really didn't want to get into this, but... Well, a few days ago, after the dock accident happened, Jerry Grove came to see me.
Jerry, about what?
He had some information about the accident. Information that he thought that I should be aware of.
Yes?
Jerry felt that what happened down there was not an accident.
Not an accident?
No. That's what he said to me.
Well, where did he get this information?
He didn't want to reveal his source, but according to what he was told, the accident wasn't an accident. It was something that was planned all along.
Planned?
Yes. With Jamie as its target.
Someone wanted to hurt Jamie?
Hurt or kill. And if it hadn't been for that young Sandy Alexander pushing Jamie to safety, I think he would have been killed.
Well, who could possibly want Jamie?
That's a question I keep asking myself. But the police are down there now investigating. Perhaps they can come up with some clue about who it was behind it.
The idea, it's inconceivable.
Yes, I know it is. Except that Jerry just seemed so sure that his information was correct.
Well, Jerry's a very level-headed young man, and I don't think he would come to you with something like this unless he was convinced.
No, and that's precisely why I took his advice and sent Jamie out of town.
Oh, then this trip of Jamie's was Jerry's idea.
Actually, yes. He felt that if there had been one attempt on Jamie's life, there might well be another.
Mac, I had no idea.
I know. Now you understand why I'm so worried that I haven't heard from him.
Well, naturally. But couldn't you call him?
Well, if I were to do that, he'd think I was trying to keep tabs on him.
Oh, but surely under the circumstances...
No, no, but you see, Jamie doesn't know the real reason that I sent him off. He thinks this was just a vacation trip with some business thrown in.
Excuse me, Mr. Bancroft. This just came by messenger. You've been expecting it.
Thank you, Nellie. Excuse me.
Sure. What is it, Brian? Bad news?
This is the autopsy report on Margot Grove.
Did they discover how she died?
Well, according to this, she died from an overdose of heroin.
Is there something the matter with Jamie?
Well, what?
I don't know. It's just the way he sounded on the phone.
Oh, you're just imagining this because Cecile's on that trip with him.
Well, I don't appreciate the fact she's on the trip with him, but I certainly expected him to sound like he was enjoying himself.
Well, maybe he enjoyed himself a little too much last night.
No, it wasn't like that. It was just something in his voice.
Like what?
I don't know. He was just sort of tense. I mean, you know, this just isn't a pleasure trip for him. He's there on business. He's doing a lot of work for Mac.
Oh, a lot of work never bothered Jamie before.
Well, I don't know. Maybe it's a combination of doing all this work and then being with Cecile.
Well, I would think that, Cecile would see to it that he didn't work all the time.
I don't know. You know, Jamie's just been made heir of Corey Publishers. Maybe he feels he has to prove to Mac that Mac did the right thing.
Oh, honey, Jamie's managed to take pretty good care of himself so far.
Yeah, except that lately he's been wearing himself so thin with all this extra work and the accident and everything.
Well, he wasn't really all that badly hurt.
Well, that's what he says.
What do you mean, that's what he says?
Well, who knows? I mean, maybe he didn't tell us something. Maybe he didn't tell us because he didn't want us to worry about him.
Well, what else do you think could be wrong with him?
Well, I don't know. Maybe I should talk to Russ.
Well, look, be careful if you do. You know, Jamie doesn't want you checking up on him.
Well, it's a mother's prerogative.
Oh, well, it's also a mother's whatever you call it to tell her daughter to be very careful when she interferes in her son's life, okay?
Well, I shouldn't think he'd resent it. No child would resent a mother trying to help.
He is not a child.
I know that.
But you're not about to listen to it, are you? I mean, you're just as stubborn as ever. Well, anyway, let's drop it. That's not really why I came here. I want to find out how Sandy's doing.
Well, at the moment, he seems to be doing pretty good.
According to that report, it seems like they really started losing their circulation over 5 years ago.
And it's been dropping steadily ever since.
Right. And then that printer's strike lasted a long time, bound to affect circulation.
Which hasn't helped the quality of the paper either.
Well, the paper just never recovered. They've been losing money steadily year after year. It's going to be a lot of hard work to repair that damage and get the circulation back up again.
Which brings us back to where we were yesterday.
Right. I hope that you're not going to take a long time deciding whether to accept or reject my offer.
Look, Mac, I've given it a lot of thought.
And?
It wasn't easy to come to a decision.
No, I'm sure it wasn't.
But...
But?
You know, I'd really like to be editor of the Daily Ledger. So I've decided to accept your offer.
You really had me going there. I was sure you were turning me down.
Yeah, I must admit to you, though, there was a moment of hesitation. But Mac, I've really always enjoyed working for you. And besides, I really feel that Bay City could use a second paper.
Great. I'm pleased, Philip. I'm very, very pleased.
Well, thank you. It's going to be good working for Corey Publishers again.
I'm glad you feel that way. And believe me, both personally and professionally, I feel that we are extremely fortunate to have a man like you on board with us.
Thank you. So now tell me, who is it who's going to be publishing the paper? You?
Well, I've decided to put Jamie in charge. It's going to be totally his responsibility.
Well, that's good. I think Jamie's very good. We work together very well.
Oh, I'm glad to hear you say that. There are a lot of people that would think he was too young to handle this much responsibility, but I really believe that he can handle it very well.
You know, I also hear that he's overseeing the dock project construction.
Hmm.
As well as his end of the publishing business.
Yeah.
Well, it's quite a heavy load, isn't it?
It is. But he assures me he can manage everything okay, at least up until this. And I know, working with good men like you, he can't fail.
Well, you look a lot better than the last time I saw you.
I feel a lot better, too.
Sit down, Sandy. I'm going to go down and fix us all some tea.
Oh, honey, don't bother. I can't stay. Okay, come on, sit down.
Yeah.
Well, how you doing?
Well, if it hadn't been for the Coreys, I don't think I'd be doing this well.
Are you comfortable here?
Yeah, very. Yeah, they're two of the most generous people I've ever met.
Yeah, well, they feel that they owe you, you know, on account of Jamie. They think a lot of him, so do I.
They don't owe me anything. I mean, anyone would have done the same.
I'm not so sure about that.
Well, I'm glad I could do it. I just don't think I can be staying here too much longer.
Why not?
I can't get over the feeling that I'm imposing on them.
Oh, don't worry about that. Mac and Rachel are glad to have you.
Yeah, but I can't count on that. I mean, I'm not very good company. All I do is sleep.
Well, that's what you're supposed to do.
Yeah, but when I sleep, I have these terrible nightmares. So when I wake up, I'm more tired than I was when I fell asleep, and I keep having these horrible headaches.
Why don't you call Dr. Matthews?
No, no, he says it's just par for the course.
Is there anything I can do?
I don't think there's anything anybody can do. I just gotta take care of it on my own.
Well, you don't have to do anything on your own. You have friends. That's what friends are for.
Thanks, Ada. It helps just knowing that.
Oh, here you go.
Sandy, would you like some tea?
No, no.
Some cookies?
No.
Okay. Mom, tell me about the beauty parlor.
Well, I'm getting anxious to open it. Thanks.
When's the opening date?
I hope next Monday.
That soon, huh?
Well, yeah, I've had a lot of help.
Mm-hmm.
Clarice and Joey and Lee. Thank you, honey. Guess who's been coming around a lot lately?
Who?
Mitch Blake.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, he's invested in the sporting life.
Yes, I know that.
He drops by once in a while to talk.
Does he?
Seems to be doing okay.
Good.
Sandy, are you all right?
Sandy, what's happening?
Sandy?
Who?
Sandy, it's me. It's Ada.
Ada? Oh, wow, I'm sorry.
Are you all right?
I just kind of went blank for a moment.
Well, don't worry about it. Dr. Matthews said that might happen.
Yeah, but this was... Look, I think I better go lie down for just a moment. Please, excuse
me.
Yeah,
let me help you.
No, I'm going to be all right. Thanks.
Are you sure?
Yeah. Yeah. Excuse me.
Jerry, the autopsy report came in on your mother. I want you to read it because, frankly, it's hard for me to understand.
What are you talking about?
Read it.
An overdose of heroin?
That's the confirmed cause of death.
My mother never used drugs. This is Jordan Scott's handiwork.
Now, Jerry, don't...
Don't what? This is his calling card. That's Jordan Scott's way of getting rid of whatever problems he doesn't want around.
Jerry, I checked. Jordan has a firmly established alibi for the time when your mother was...
Murdered. Now, that doesn't surprise me. Jordan Scott is too smart to get his own hands dirty, but believe me, he is responsible for this.
Now, Jerry...
Then he had someone else do it. I know it.
Jerry, promise me that you won't do anything rash.
What can I do? There is nothing that I can do. Yet. Look, Brian, I'm sorry. It's just that I have to get down to the morgue and arrange to transfer my mother's body.
Is there anything I can do for you?
No, thanks, Brian.
I could go with you.
No. This is something that I've got to do by myself. It's one of several things that I'm going to have to do by myself.
Liz, would you hold all my calls, please? I want to do some work here, and I don't want to be interrupted. Thank you, Liz. Marion. It's been so many years. Why do I think of you now? Why? After all the turns my life has taken, do my thoughts now come back again to you? February 24th, 1981. Unedited notes. Subject: Mackenzie Corey. My life. Chapter 7. Miriam Sanderson. I was in my early 30s when I first met Miriam. She was a young widow with a small daughter. Her husband was missing in action in the Korean War, presumed dead. It's hard, looking back, to recall exactly what it was that brought us together. But I will never forget what we came to mean to each other over those months we shared. I was attracted to Miriam first time I saw. We became very close. Hardly a day passed, but we saw each other. We seemed to have so much in common. Miriam and I could talk for hours with each other. Finally, the inevitable happened. We fell into an affair. Some of the happiest moments of my life were spent with Miriam. I wanted to marry her, but she resisted. She was afraid that her husband might come back someday. And then she learned something which changed the life that we had more and more shared together.
Miriam, what's bothering you? Now, wait a minute. I can tell you've been distracted all evening.
I went to the doctor today.
All right. You went to the doctor? Are you ill?
No. No, nothing like that. It was something else.
Well, come on, tell me what it was.
I'm pregnant.
You're pregnant? Oh, sweetheart, how wonderful. Oh, darling, don't cry. Don't be unhappy. You should be happy. This is a happy occasion. Our baby, we're going to have a baby. Our love's going to make a baby come into this world. I want to do something to make you happy.
Oh, Mac, you don't understand.
I do understand, and I want to get married tomorrow. No, I want to get married tonight. Oh, sweetheart. I'm so happy. I love the idea of us having a baby. Oh, Miriam, you make me so happy.
We were going to be married the next day. But she left in the middle of the night. I never heard from her again. I tried for months and months to locate her. But for me, it was as if she had disappeared off the face of the earth. Of course, I couldn't help wondering if the baby had been born, and was it a daughter, or was it a son?
Easy. In a week, maybe 10 days, I want you to take this to your regular doctor and have the sutures removed. If you don't have a doctor, you can come back here, make an appointment, and we'll take them out for you, okay? Easy now, keep that up. Okay. Rachel.
Good afternoon, Doctor. You have time for an old friend?
Well, of course I have time. Come on in. Here, wait a minute. Let me get you a seat over here. Okay. There you are.
Thank you.
Sit down.
Okay.
How are you?
All right.
You look fine.
Thank you.
Oh, gee, I never had a chance to congratulate you on your detective work.
Detective work?
Yes, the way you found Mitch, that was amazing.
Oh.
And what a relief to hear that you were absolved of that murder charge.
Yes, it really was a relief. Russ, did you ever get my note? I'm still terribly shocked and sorry about Tracy.
Yes, I did. Thank you.
Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. Fine. How are you?
Oh, I'm fine.
Well, then you didn't come to me with a medical problem. What can I do for you?
Well, I came in to talk to you about Jamie.
What about him?
How serious are his injuries?
Oh, aside from a bruise on his head and a sprained arm, he's going to be fine.
You sure there's nothing else?
Yes, I'm sure. Why? Why do you ask?
Well, I was just worried that there was something wrong, something that he didn't want to tell us about.
Well, no, nothing that I'm aware of, but what makes you ask? There must be some reason for your concern.
You know he's out of town on that trip for Mac.
I know that. I gave him the go-ahead to leave.
Well, he just called me today, and he sounded funny.
Sound? How exactly did he sound, Rachel?
Well, I don't know. He just sounded tired and disinterested and... Well, I don't know. It's just a feeling I have.
It's got to be something more than that. Now, one sleepy-sounding phone call is not enough to get you down here.
Well, I've just been concerned about him. He's been working so terribly hard. And then the accident and then the phone call, and it just all alarmed me.
Well, a sprained arm is certainly enough to make sleeping uncomfortable, but not impossible. Besides, I did give him sleeping pills so that he'd be sure to get plenty of sleep on this trip.
I see. Well, it's obviously someone else, then, that's keeping him from getting his rest.
Someone else. Do I detect a note of cynicism in there? Now, let me see. You couldn't by any chance be referring to Cecile de Polignac
okay,
when you say someone.
Guessed it right.
Yes.
You're needed in examining room 7 right away.
Oh, thank you. Honey, I'm sorry. Will you excuse
me? Yeah, sure, sure. Well, Alice, welcome home.
Thank you. It's good to be home again.
I'm sure it is.
How's Jamie?
Oh, he's terrific. He's on a business trip for Mac right now.
I was really glad to hear that his injuries from that accident were so minor.
Oh, we were too. We were very lucky. How's Sally?
Oh, she's doing very well.
Mm-hmm.
She's really growing into a lovely young lady.
She's in school?
Yes, she's back in school. Her first year of college.
Oh, my gosh.
As soon as semester exams are over, she's going to join me here in Bay City.
Oh, she's moving back then.
Well, I'm hoping that she will transfer to Bay State.
Mm-hmm.
But, of course, that's going to have to be her decision.
Well, it sounds then that you're deciding to stay here.
Yes, I believe I am. I liked Chicago, but, well, my family's here. I grew up here, and well, in spite of everything that's happened here, I still feel this is my home.
Sure it is.
I wanted to see you. Am I interrupting?
Oh, not at all. What can I do for you?
Rumor has it you have Dr. Delaney's appointment book.
Yes, that's true.
Okay, she wanted me to check, see about making an appointment.
Well, you wait right here. I'll find out for you. Mr. Good to see you.
Nice to see you.
Thank you. How are you?
Fine. How are you?
All right. Are you all right?
Sure.
Well, I just thought...
Oh, no, 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 no. No, I was just in to see Russ about something, nothing serious.
Good.
Well, look, you certainly have...
You first.
Okay. I was just going to say you haven't been over to see Matthew in a while.
No, I thought with everything going on with Jamie that it'd be better if I just stayed away.
Oh, Mitch, you're always welcome to come see your son whenever you want to.
Then I will come over.
Good. He'll be pleased to see you.
Well, I figured he probably doesn't even know who I am.
No, I don't think so. I don't think that's true at all.
No?
No.
At that age, I assumed that one pair of hands holding him was as... Just like another pair of hands.
No, that's not true. I don't believe that for one minute. I think babies very early on identify people who love them.
Then I will be over there before he forgets.
Good. I think you should. You're here to see Dr. Delaney?
No, just to make an appointment.
Problems?
No. On the contrary, I've been remembering some things and I found that I'm putting some of the pieces back together.
Just a second. Come on in.
Hi.
Hi.
Am I disturbing you?
No, no, not at all.
Seems like we're the only ones left in the house.
Yeah, well, Rachel had to go out. She dropped Matthew and Amanda at the babysitter. I offered to watch them, but...
Oh, no, you're not supposed to babysit. You're supposed to rest.
Well, it wouldn't be any trouble, really. I like kids a lot.
That's something we have in common, then. Are you okay?
Yes, just, that's just my head.
Can I get you something for it?
Please, Dr. Matthews, gave me some pills. They're on the dresser there.
Right here?
Yeah.
How many?
Just one. Thank you.
Hope it's fast working.
Thanks a lot. Ooh.
Would you like to be left alone?
No, no, not at all. As a matter of fact, I think a little conversation might take my mind off the headache.
Good enough. Long time since I've been in this room. It used to be Jamie's, you know, when he lived here with his mother and me.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess that.
He won these on his high school swim team. He was very good at it. I always thought he should go out for basketball. You know, he's lean and long. But he never seemed to go for team sports.
How old was Jamie when you and Mrs. Corey married?
A little more than 14.
Oh, that must have been hard on you. Instant fatherhood, I mean.
No, actually not at all. From the very first, Jamie seemed like a real son to me.
It's nice.
It was very nice. Especially since I've always wanted a boy of my own.
Why did Jamie never take the Corey name?
Oh, well, that was in deference to his father, Steve Frame. But after all, what's in a name? Jamie was my son as much as any father can have a son, blood tie or no blood tie.
Yeah. I think Jamie's very lucky to have you for a stepfather.
Well, thank you. I know that I'm very lucky to have him for my son.
Nurse, have you... Dr. Matthews,
yeah.
Have you seen Kit Holloway around?
No, I don't think she's on duty right now, Jerry. Do you try the cafeteria?
No, I haven't, thanks.
Oh, hold on, just a second, Jerry. Would you file that, please?
Something wrong?
No, I just have to talk to Kit.
Slow down a little bit. Come on over here and have a seat. What's bothering you? You look like you're about to explode.
Well, I got the autopsy report back this morning, and I have to deal with the final arrangements for my mother. That's all.
That's all. That's quite a lot, especially if you have to do it yourself.
Yeah, well, I've got to do it.
Jerry, you don't have any family here in Bay City? Nobody to help out?
No, it was just my mother and me. She had a brother, but he passed away a few years ago, and his family was never that close to us.
Listen, if you want somebody to talk to, well, I'm here.
Thanks, Dr. Matthews, but...
Listen, I know what you're going through. Been there myself just recently. All right, so I'm not going to be able to do anything, but at least I will understand.
This looks terrific.
Hmm?
Well, the work you've done, it looks just great. What'd you think I was talking about?
Oh, nothing. Glad you're here. Been alone all afternoon. It's beginning to get lonely.
Oh, well, Clarice had to go pick up some beauty supplies, and Joey is putting in a little time at the arena. He's also getting ready to move into his new apartment. Hey.
Oh.
Hey. What'd I just say?
What? I
don't know. Oh, come on. Where are the bodies here and the beds all gone?
Well, I'm sorry. I just been thinking about something.
Something important. Girls.
No. Larry.
Well, Larry. What about Larry?
He hasn't come home for several nights now.
I know. Clarice told me.
Do you know where he is?
Well, Clarice thinks that he's staying at the arena.
That's weird.
What's weird?
He was telling me how he hated the place. Made a big deal about it and everything, and now, look.
Well, I'll tell you something, honey. When you least expect it, people just turn around and change on you.
I don't know, Larry and Clarice are so right together.
Yeah, I know.
It kills me to see Larry throwing that away. And for what? I just can't sit idly by and watch it happen.
Now,
I can't let it happen.
Honey, look. You can't solve their problems for them. They gotta work this out themselves.
And if they don't, what then?
Hey, listen, I'm sorry for going on like that. Must be a big bore for you.
No, I don't find it boring at all.
You know, Sandy, I know almost nothing about you.
Me?
All I know is you're new in Bay City. You were working at the construction dock, and you saved Jamie's life.
Yeah, well, that's my life story as far as Bay City goes. What else would you like to know?
Well, what else would you like to tell me?
I can't think that anything I'd tell you would be very interesting.
I like you, Sandy. And the lives of the people I like are very interesting to me.
Well, I don't know, Mr. Corey.
Well, let's say, for starters, where'd you grow up? Where'd you go to school?
Oh, Southern California, mostly.
Ah, beautiful country.
Yeah, the country is beautiful. Now, the place itself, it's definitely an E-coupon all the way.
E-coupon? That's a slang expression I'm not familiar with.
Oh, well, you know Disneyland.
Yeah.
Well, In Disneyland, all the most outrageous rides and attractions, well, they all require an eat coupon to get on, so...
I get it. So what do you think Bay City is?
Well, I don't know. I haven't really seen that much of it.
I think maybe that's just a polite observation. What brought you to Bay City, anyway?
I don't know.
Well, it must have been some kind of connection, friends or family tie of some kind.
Well, I guess you could say a family tie from way back.
Well, there you are.
Yes, here I am.
Where have you been?
I went to talk to Russ at the hospital.
What about?
Oh, well, Jamie called this morning, and he sounded funny. I got worried about him. I thought maybe he was keeping something from us. You know, something about the accident.
So he went to see Russ?
Yeah. He said he's fine.
Russ said he was just tired, right?
Yep, right.
Still, I'm certainly glad he called you. I've been a little concerned.
About what?
Well, nothing in particular. I just wanted to hear from him.
Oh. Well, he said to be sure and tell you that he called. And also, Cecile wants to talk to you about your memoirs. Have you decided to go ahead with that?
Yeah, I've been talking about it for so long, I've finally begun.
For publication?
No. What's the matter? Don't you think my life is interesting enough for people to want to read it?
Yes, too interesting.
No, it's not for publication. Just for me to leave behind.
Well, I hope you're not leaving us behind very soon.
Me too.
And besides, she'll be mentioning your memoirs.
Oh, she's helping me edit.
Why not Jamie?
Because he has too much to do at the moment. He's going to have much more to do in the months to come. I don't want to saddle him with another assignment.
Well, do you think Cecile is the right choice for it?
I don't know. Why not?
Well, I'm not sure I want Cecile to have access to the story of your life.
Join us each weekday at this time for the continuing story of Another Work.